Welcome back, everyone. Join us to make a gorgeous holiday entree. Cider Baked Ham is cookbook author and host of America's Test Kitchen, our very good friend, Julia Collin Davison.
Thank you. We love it when you're here. Thank you. We know
that whatever you make for us has been tested 7,000 times.
You got it. It will be absolutely delicious.
You got it.
Well, the thing about the ham is it's super easy. I mean, anyone can do this. And it's the centerpiece for most holidays. So you want to nail it.
Well, you know everyone's going to be ham for the holidays. So so let's talk ham then. So what's the best ham to buy? What do you look for when you buy a ham?
Well, there's two kinds of hams. Okay. There's city ham and country ham, right?
Oh, nice.
So city ham has been brined. I know it has a sort of a wet cure, whereas country ham has a dry cure, and it's often smoked. So you think about Virginia hams.
Right. Sure, that's where I'm from.
Yeah. So they have kind of a different cooking technique. Now, this is a city ham. Most city hams are spiral sliced. So if you get a spiral sliced ham,
that's a city ham.
Now, spiral sliced are great because they're really easy to serve. Okay. But you can also find them unsliced, like this one, which means you have more fat on the outside. And when you have more fat and
flavor,
you have, you get those little crunchy bits after it's done roasting.
That's the best part.
Is it considered
uncool to serve a pre-cut ham? Is that like, if you're like a real chef, that's totally
fine. If you're serving ham, you're a rock star.
You're good.
Exactly.
If anyone complains, you know where to send them.
Send them home.
Yeah.
Do you always buy the ham with the bone in?
Oh, yeah.
Always.
Bone has flavor, right?
Okay.
And plus, you can use the bone afterwards to make soups.
Ham hock.
Yeah. The bone's flavor.
All right. So how do we prepare our ham?
Yeah. So this is, you want a 7 to 10 pound ham.
Oh, I mean,
this is a monster. It's going to serve a lot. And you notice it has some fat on it. You want to trim the fat back till it's about a quarter of an inch thick.
Okay.
And then you want to score it. You just use a sharp knife. And here, you can just see, you can just score it right through the fat, all the way down to, but not through the meat. And you want about an inch.
Just through the fat, not to the meat.
That's
not too
it.
Deep.
Okay. Yeah, you want that fat to render as it roasts. Thank you.
Oh, yes.
And so you do this all over the ham. I'll just do a quick
one. Cross cut.
Yes.
And you can tell because it just stops when you get to the meat.
That's it. Yeah, you can feel, it feels different on the knife. The meat, definitely. And you can see, you make that sort of iconic crosshatch pattern.
The,
and that's
the
key.
One.
Yeah.
So, and then we brine.
You got to brine it.
For how long?
Well, for 4 to 12 hours. The longer you brine, the more flavor you get. And we're going to brine this in cider with some spices, really get some sugar and flavor in there.
Okay.
Okay, so in the fridge that goes for, you know, up to 12 hours.
All right.
Overnight makes it easy. Do it the day before.
Can you brine too long? Like how with chicken, if you marinate too long, it breaks down?
Weird. So brining isn't like marinating because there's no acid in there. It's just sugar. But it will get too moist.
Okay.
I mean, if it was in there an extra 12 hours, not the end of the world.
Okay.
More than a day, it starts to get a bit funky.
Okay.
Okay.
So then you can see, I put it in a roasting pan. You see this bag?
In the baking
bag. This bag is where it's at, because the ham's already cooked, right? We're just reheating it. You don't want to dry it out.
So this is basically like the turkey bag.
It is.
Okay, same
so
thing.
You put it in. This has been in the oven for about 2 hours at 300 degrees.
All right.
And there's a little bit of cider.
Oh, my gosh, look at it already.
I know.
And that's only
you get
2 hours.
Smell. Oh, isn't that good?
And now we actually glaze the ham.
Yeah, so I made a glaze by reducing some cider, more apple cider with a few more spices. And what we're going to do, I'm going to use a glove.
All right. Yeah, it's always better with your hands. Better with your hands.
Doctor.
I love it. Use the same glaze with a spiral cut?
Of course. Oh, yeah. You can use it on anything. You can put it on tofu. It'll make tofu.
Yeah, it's true. That glaze is delicious.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, it's glaze.
It has some mustard in it as well.
Absolutely, yep.
Okay.
So a little bit of that tang of the mustard and a little bit of the cider. It has a nice counterpoint.
Mm.
All right, so now we're just going to kind of, you want to just...
Yeah, ooze it all over.
Yeah.
You need to wait till it's cooled off
No.
Right away.
Yeah. Right?
Now we're talking.
Oh, yeah. So, because it looks kind of wet on the outside. Now we're going to put... Yeah, I know. Oh, it's getting
That's
better.
That's Instagrammable. Somebody take a picture. And then we pack it with our dry,
right?
Because
you
is sugar and pepper.
That's it. Brown sugar and pepper.
Okay.
And you just take this mixture, right? Mm-hmm. You just pack it on.
Oh,
oh my!
Oh yeah, this is
wow.
I know. And so we're gonna put this. I'm gonna put this all over the ham. It's about a cup of brown sugar and about a teaspoon of black pepper to give you an idea of some of the amounts. Just pack it on.
How many times did you test this one?
I tested this one even after we were done with the recipe. This is good.
Yeah,
you know?
Like Julia, we have it. The recipe's good.
Yeah. I have one more question for you guys. So you just kind of pack it on, and then this goes back into a 400-degree oven, uncovered, and all this sugar is going to melt. It's going to glaze the ham. So it goes back in the oven for about 20 minutes.
Okay.
So
that's it? Just 20 minutes?
Yeah, it's all cooked. You just got to cook the outside of it.
All right. And then... Ladies and gentlemen,
oh my God,
look at what comes out of the oven. Isn't that beautiful?
I know. Oh, here,
now it's time to slice, though. Okay. Is there a specific way to slice this?
Yes.
There's a key, right?
Of course there is.
So, Ken, if you're serving pre-sliced ham, or if you're cutting
it. I know, I need to pay attention. I want to upgrade to the non.
This will work for both pre-sliced and unsliced. Now, this is, you just got to get your hands dirty, right? It's a big, heavy, slippery piece of meat. Okay. Pick it up. You put it cut side down. That's kind of the key, so it won't rock. And, of course, the bone goes right through the center. This is what you do in the kitchen. Don't do this at the table, right? It's like carving a turkey. It's a mess.
Okay.
So do it in the privacy of your kitchen, then wash your hands. Bring out a gorgeous platter, right?
And then lay the bone there maybe with it, too, to make it look so beautiful.
Oh, yeah. So, you'd see, you can just go through. This is all meat. You can go. See?
So you cut straight down like
that. Yes.
Okay.
And then you can, you can put that aside. And then you can just make these beautiful, here, I'll put this around this way. You can just make these beautiful slices.
See, Rodney's over here making all like,
Are you kidding me?
And then, you can just make these beautiful. Yeah.
So you're saying you can do this with a spiral cut as well? Because a spiral, you put the whole thing, and then it's always kind of a mess because it doesn't go all the way.
Yeah, so the spiral cut means it's cut this way.
So,
so if you cut down this way, it'll just be sliced for
you. That's right. Yeah.
But if it's not spiral sliced, it's a little bit more moist, and you can cut thicker slices.
And you're like serving it with this beautiful arugula salad with prosciutto and parmesan.
Did you try the salad?
So it's arugula salad, and the key is to put a little bit of jam in the dressing, because it just helps cut through with a fruity sweetness on that bitter arugula.
But this is just one of the recipes in your new cookbook, by the way, Cooking at Home with Bridget and Julia. But there are a lot of other recipes in the book that you could serve this ham with as well, and I'd love to show everybody some
of that. There's this potato fennel gratin. This is on my holiday table all the time. Yeah, because the fennel is just nice with the potatoes.
Oh, that's
roasted
beautiful.
Butternut squash.
Oh.
That is amazing. Yeah, a little bit of feta over the top. And asparagus. This is easy broiled.
Now you're making the sounds.
Ham-roasted asparagus.
Not that there's any leftovers at my house ever, but what do you do with the leftovers?
So the ham, as I mentioned earlier, split pea soup is classic.
Yes.
I love making frittatas. So frittata with leftover ham and any of the other vegetables you have around.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah, that just with
for
some
breakfast
eggs.
The next day.
That's it. And I'm a big hash fam. I turn anything
into hash. Oh,
yes.
Oh, my
put
gosh.
Put an egg on it.
Yes.
Put an egg on it. I am with you, Julia. Are
put ham on it. Put ham on it. That's it. I love it.
Oh, you have to taste this, Julia.
Oh, look at this. Look how juicy it is.
I know.
That's hard to do.
I can't believe it's only 2 hours and 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers. All in the bag, right?
All right. The full recipe will be available for download on our home and family holiday recipes and crafts book on HallmarkChannel.com, and you can connect with Julia on her website.
My goodness.
We have a fantastic show ahead with sage advice from Shirley.
Ooh, and it's good advice, too, to keep your sage plants blooming all summer long.
Can't wait for that. Plus, beauty expert Ami Desai has the hottest looks for us. Hi, Ami.
Hello. So I have some amazing holiday hairstyles that look pretty intricate but are super easy to do.
But next, we're getting a sneak peek on how Hallmark's premier keepsake artists create their stunning ornaments.
Come on back, everybody.